way for you.
Oregon versus Alabama for the national championship. None of this stuff matters. Here's what people keep forgetting. It is a long season. Great. Congratulations, Ole Miss and Mississippi State. You still got to deal with the rest of the SEC West. You still got to deal with the Auburns of the world. You still got to deal with all those nasty teams. Arizona's not going to go undefeated. So to get in the college football playoff, you're going to pretty much have to win your conference championship anyway. Now there's just no margin for error. I think Oregon fixes the glitch. I think they go on from here. They beat UCLA. I think they win the Pac-12 title. I think Alabama rolls from here. I think it's still going to be Alabama for Oregon. I am sticking with my
preseason. You're not worried about
pitch.
The row line?
Not at all.
Okay.
What I learned from the weekend was that all eyes were on the SEC, but what happened down there, I wasn't shocked by. I expected that to happen. But looking at college football, and I watched that Michigan State and that Nebraska game, to me now, Ohio State is probably the best team in the Big Ten. They're playing very, very well. JT Barrett's finally come along. The last 2 weeks, he's passed for almost 600 yards, 8 touchdowns, no interceptions, 75% completion percentage, and he's also run for over 145 yards. He's looking like what they wanted him to look like week one. He wasn't ready then. He's ready now. If they played Michigan State today, they'd beat them. So what does that do to the college football picture, playoff picture? I don't know, because every week something crazy happens. But in the Big Ten, everybody needs to turn their eyes back to the Ohio State Buckeyes.